Phantom, how's it going? Today we are reviewing the one, the only, and the much-loved Punisher Max by Garth Ennis. The series is written by Garth Ennis, and if you've never read anything by Garth Ennis, the guy's not exactly known for his subtlety. He's done series like Preacher, Fury Max, The Boys, all very mature and R-rated stuff. And this is no exception, because the Punisher in this is brutal, it's raw, it's unflinching, and it is at times even heartbreaking. One of the first things that you're going to notice about this is an older, gruffer Punisher. And what Ennis did that was really smart was that he actually took Punisher back and said, yeah, this guy fought in Vietnam. Because what happened was in the 90s, Marvel decided, yeah, our characters never really aged, so let's bump up the timeline a little bit, and let's say Punisher fought in the Gulf War instead of Vietnam. I think that was a bit of a problem because of the fact that I think that the psychological scarring and the things that Punisher went through, Vietnam had such a huge part of that, and he's such a character from that time and that moment. The general story of this follows kind of a certain pattern throughout the whole thing. What's happening is that you've got a group of people, usually a gang or a mafia or a terrorist organization, that they say, hey, we want to take down the Punisher, we have a way of doing it that nobody else has a way of doing it. And they try, and they fail. What's great about this also is that Ennis understands that Punisher isn't exactly the deepest character in the world, and I'm probably going to get a lot of hate for this. So what he does is that he surrounds Frank Castle with characters that are actually more intriguing and more interesting, and he kind of makes Punisher this force, this kind of hurricane that comes through, and he messes things up, and he takes care of people, and he takes care of the problem. Meanwhile, adding on likable characters and fleshing out those side characters and kind of giving Frank somebody that, yeah, he would fight for this person, he would die for this person, and you see that he would go through all these things for this person. One of the great things about this run is that Ennis does not shy away from controversial topics. There is a volume in here called The Slavers, and if you get to this volume, I'm telling you right now, it is probably one of the most heartbreaking things you will ever read. Because when you get to the end of the volume, you see the fallout of human trafficking and how it affects somebody. And Ennis does not shy away from it. And it's just something where I just put the book down, I went to the kitchen, and I poured myself a drink and just relaxed. Because I just could not deal with it at the end of it. It was just so raw and so much just truth and honesty. And it's just, oh, it hits you right here and you're like, oh my gosh. And this type of stuff happens a lot. Ennis also has a way of kind of creating these really cool and iconic villains. One of them is like this guy who he's got his face peeled off and he's got this plastic mask. And it's just really freaky and really nasty looking. Just gives me chills just thinking about it. Another one is Barracuda. Barracuda is over the top, to say the least, crazy and fun. And when Frank Castle finally goes after him, you're like, yes, I cannot wait to see Frank take this guy down. Is on. It's going to be so much fun. If the run had a weak point, I would definitely have to say it was Widowmaker. Not that Widowmaker is a bad story. In fact, it's actually a really good one. It's just when you're following up so many different and iconic moments from Garth Ennis's run, to come to Widowmaker, it's kind of like, okay, you know, this was good. It's an interesting concept where Frank Castle has to deal with the wives of the mafia men that he's killed and how they are now going after him. Really cool, really interesting stuff, but kind of the low point. It bounces back later on, though, to a stunning climax and conclusion. And I'm telling you, make it through Widowmaker. This is volume 8, and finish up the run. You won't regret it. Let's get into the art for a moment. So Goran Parlov and Leandro Fernandez are the guys that you're going to see the most inside of this run. Unfortunately, Ennis did not have a steady artist throughout the entire thing, so we had fill-ins and things like that. However, all the way through, the art is solid. They capture all the moments that they need to capture. They hit all the story beats that they need to capture. And oh my gosh, it is brutal, it is violent, and sometimes it is just comically so how over the top the story can get. But really, it's just a lot of fun. In total, there are 10 trades, and I'm going to show you them right now. So, you got the first one. The beginning, right there. Then you get volume 2, Kitchen Irish. Volume 3, Mother Russia, where Frank Castle has to go to Russia. Is to deal with something Nick Fury's got him doing. I'm not going to give that away, but that was a good story in there. Then volume 4, Upside Down, Black is White. And The Slavers, which I actually may do just a review on the Slavers alone, because to me it is the best story inside of the run. Not that the other ones were bad, it's just this one was at another level. Then Barracuda, where you get introduced to the iconic Punisher villain Barracuda. Man of Stone, Volume 7. Widowmaker, Volume 8. Long Cold Dark, Volume 9. And the final one, Valley Forge. It's the last one. Overall, if you've ever been interested in the Punisher, this is the run to get. I'm telling you right now, if you get this, you will be completely spoiled. No other Punisher run compares to what Garth Ennis has done on this. Yes, Jason Aaron did come after him, and he did an okay job, but Garth Ennis is the guy that laid the foundation. He did the best Punisher stories that have ever been told, in my opinion, and I think you will love this if you even have just a slight interest in the character. If this is your first time checking out my channel, I do weekly reviews of hardcovers and trade paperbacks and pretty much anything comic book related. Let me know in the comment section down below what your favorite Punisher story is. Follow me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter, comment, subscribe. You guys are awesome. Bye.